How are you feeling now? That was November Rain from Guns N' Roses, of course. Claire Dodd in Folkestone. I had my first kiss to that song. November Rain, when this was released in 1991, I was 18, working in a music shop in County Dublin. I remember blasting up the volume after closing time. Still love this song today. Chris and Kirsty in Wales. Remember the concert broadcast live from France? They cut November Rain just before Flash did his... Flash? Slash did his historic solo. Thanks for listening to the show. You got Jamie Cullum on the way with an hour of jazz. Lucky you. Take care. See you on a treadmill tomorrow with Scott. On the BBC Sounds app, on your smart speaker, and on 88 to 91 FM's time for the news.
BBC News at 9 o'clock. This is Harvey Cook. There are reports that at least one Russian missile has hit a Polish village near the Ukrainian border, killing two people. If confirmed, this would mark the first time a missile has landed on a NATO member's territory since Russia's full-scale invasion of Ukraine in February. Emergency meetings have been convened in Poland and Hungary. Officials in Moscow have described the reports as a provocation with the aim of escalation. Kirk Volker is a former U.S. ambassador to NATO and gave his assessment.
My own judgment is that this was an accident. I don't think Russia intended to attack NATO, and I don't think NATO wants to escalate into a conflict with Russia, but we need an explanation from Russia. And NATO also needs to issue a warning that it will not tolerate attacks on NATO territory, whether or not they are accidents in the future, and that any such future attack, accidental or not, would be met with a proportionate response.
The Pentagon has repeated a promise to defend every inch of NATO territory, but said it was assessing the details of the situation before determining appropriate next steps. A NATO official said the organization was looking into the reports and closely coordinating with Poland. Well, the development in Poland comes after a day of missile attacks on cities across Ukraine. Kyiv said Russia had carried out the biggest attacks on its energy infrastructure since the start of the war. Officials said 7 million households were without power. Residential areas in central Kyiv were also struck, leaving at least one person dead. In other news, a coroner has concluded the death of a toddler in his family's flat in Greater Manchester was directly linked to mould exposure. 2-year-old Awab Ishak died in 2020 from a severe respiratory condition. His father had repeatedly raised complaints with Rochdale Borough-wide housing, but no action was taken. An investigation has been launched after the personal details of sex abuse victims appeared on the Suffolk Police website. A spokeswoman for Rape Crisis warned that any leak could put women at threat of further violence. The Conservative Police and Crime Commissioner for Suffolk, Tim Passmore, issued an unreserved apology for the breach.
I gather it was names and addresses of victims, and I can understand the huge concern that might have caused people, which is why I've issued that apology. I have asked the Chief Constable and the Deputy Chief Constable to expedite this investigation as quickly as possible so the lessons are learned, and if there are changes that need to be made, they're put in place as quickly as we possibly can.
England's footballers have touched down in Qatar ahead of the World Cup, which begins this weekend. They'll begin their campaign on Monday when they face Iran. The Wales squad is due to arrive in Doha later. Our sports editor Dan Rowan is there and says the focus on off-the-pitch issues isn't likely to go away.
I think such has been the concern during the build-up towards the treatment of migrant workers, but also the discriminatory laws here in Qatar. That tradition is going to be tested here like never before. The organisers point to labour reforms. They insist that all will be welcome, but there's no doubt the eyes of the world are on Qatar and there is a huge amount at stake for the hosts.
And that's the BBC News.
Jamie Cullum.
On BBC.
Radio 2.
Good evening, everybody. This is Jamie Cullum. I am back with another hour of jazz right here on BBC Radio 2. And this week, coming from a hotel room in Bavaria, in Germany. I'm currently on tour, and as you know, I always take the show with you wherever I go. So you find me this week in a I've got to say, it's nothing wrong with this hotel room, but there are no major distinguishing features about where I am. I've got some gigs here in Germany this week, and I thought I'd prepare the show for you right here, tonight, with music from Madlib, a new track from Ezra Collective, plus a new track from Tawia. It's always good to hear new music from Tawia. I'm also going to get going tonight with someone else it's always good to hear from, Billie Holiday and Teddy Wilson. This is a track that was recorded 86 years ago this week. It also features the clarinetist Benny Goodman. This is Pennies from Heaven.